taking a closer look at charter schools. I'm Jill Horner. This is Comcast Newsmakers. With me is Pennsylvania State Representative James Roebuck. Thanks for being with us.
Thank you.
Let's talk a little bit about charter schools in general. You're the Democratic chairman of the House Education Committee, and you're having some upcoming hearings related to charter schools. But are charter schools different than public schools, or are they the same?
Charter schools are public schools. What charters are designed to be are more innovative in the sense that they have different basic rules of how they function. They have different requirements in terms of their selection of faculty. In charters, up to a quarter of the teachers do not have to be certified. But the idea of charters was out of the concept that these should be models for educational reform, models for educational intervention. If you read the first paragraph of the charter law as passed, it talks about doing that, demonstrating educational innovation, and then replicating it, establishing models that can be replicated. And that's in part the problem, is that requirement has not been fully met, not been fully fulfilled.
So let's talk about where we stand right now. Are children, first of all, being given a fair opportunity to go to these charter schools?
That's a good question. I think that one of the problems is that there are many parents who feel that they are not being given fair opportunity to go, and that in fact they do not accept all categories of students who want a public education. So part of the issue is that you need some clearer standards of accountability. You need to be more careful in terms of assessing what charters do and that they're in fact being fair to all students, all parents.
So if these are in fact public schools, how are students given the opportunity to go to charters?
There's an application process in many charters. There's in some cases lotteries, in some cases there's selection, an internal selection process. There's no consistency, a single way in which you can go to a charter. So some schools do things one way, some do them another way.
What about for classifications of students, particularly for special education students? How are students classified when it comes to special education for charter schools if these are public schools?
One of the complaints I get very vehemently from special education parents is that their kids do not get an opportunity in many cases to go to charters. And there is a special irony in this, in that we have a number of proposals in the legislature that are designed to reform charters. And the governor has chosen to put into those bills a special education law. So you're mixing two things together that aren't necessarily compatible, and there's a great deal of anger, resentment by special education parents that they are being held hostage to schools that don't necessarily meet their children's needs.
And we just have a short time left, but does this speak to the overall concern that you have related to accountability and charters?
I think there are a number of different things about accountability. It's about ensuring that all students have access. It's about making sure that financially they're responsible, making sure that they follow necessary audit procedures, that they do all those things that make them accountable for using public tax dollars.
Come back, give us an update. Let us know how your hearings progress.
Certainly will.
Thank you. We've been talking with Pennsylvania State Representative Jim Roebuck. I'm Jill Horner.